In the beginning, Rex Lapis descended. He lured the tides, raised Mount Tianheng, and calmed the waves. Thereupon, peace was brought to the people. They cut into the mountain and found jade. They bored through the rock and made tunnels. And they piled up stones and built a settlement. It is written that the jade from the bowels of the mountain is that which glows. Hence, they named it Shanhui Fort. In that time, all the people of Tianheng derived their livelihood from the mines. All prospered from them, and none knew poverty within a 1,000-mile radius. Better known today as Shanhui Rock, which is often simplified to Mountain Rock, thereby stripping the name of most of its original meaning. Guizhong, the Lord of Dust, was an ally to the Lord of Rock. Around Mount Tianheng, Guizhong set up a crossbow to keep guard, and it was named the Guizhong Ballista. She brought her people to the north of Mount Tianheng and taught them to tend the soil. Agriculture became their livelihood, and all prospered from it. The farming town stretched for miles, and it was said that one could walk all the way to the stone gate without ever leaving the network of pathways between the fields. Guizhong said to the Lord of Rock, "My people had left their home and came to this place. Here they are happy in their abodes and content in their work. Thus it is as if they have returned home." Hence, what better name to call this place than the Plains of Returning and Departing? The Lord of Rock praised the Lord of Dust for her work, and thereafter, the area was named in the tongue of Liye, Guili Plains. It later came to pass that the gods each strove for dominance, which brought catastrophe upon the land. Though the Adepti fought hard to protect the Guili Plains, they could not stop the tide of war, which ravaged the plains and took the life of its ruler, Guizhong. Thereupon, the Lord of Rock Rex Lapis took his people south of Mount Tianheng. Thus the people departed from the Guili Plains for good, never to return, and it was left to become a wilderness. Rex Lapis pacified the gods, Adepti and Yakshas were content in their positions, and Liye re-entered an era of peace. Before this time, the gods waged war for centuries on end, and not one field was left unravaged. The people of Liye turned to commerce and artisanship for their livelihood and prospered once more. Those who prospered above the rest joined together, calling themselves the Qixing. Thus was formed the framework around which Liye Harbor developed. Under the jurisdiction of the Qixing were all the known trades. No business of Liye took place inside or outside the nation that was not known unto them. The Milileth also took orders from the Qixing, supporting the masses at home and suppressing the monsters at the border. Thus became the nature of Liye's governance under Rex Lapis.
当初、岩王が降りて大波を退治、天候を断ち、川を沈める。民がついに安定し、山を開き、玉を取り、岩を破り、四方をつなぐ。いわく、玉をはまれば山が輝く。ゆえに、三鬼祭と名付けられる。当時、天候の民は採掘をなりわいとし、千里に及ぶまで貧困者はいなかったという。中、三鬼祭は現在、三鬼岩と転じ、大廃し岩と化して、当初の風貌を再び拝めることはできなくなった。使用魔人の名は奇襲という。岩王と親しいがゆえ、奇襲記という共同を設置し天候を守る。また民を引き、天候の北へと住まい、他を耕す。前世紀は交通が発達し、町屋田が石門まで絶えず続いた。奇襲は岩王にこう告げる。我が離れの民、皆故郷に帰ったかのごとく安穏に暮らしている。ここを桐原と名付けてはいかがか、と。それに岩王がうなずく。これが桐原の名の由来である。中、その後、魔人が地位をめぐる大乱を起こす。諸仙人が力を尽くす桐原を死守したが、困難の中、桐原も戦の苦難に見舞われ、塵の神も死に至った。故に、岩王帝君はその民を率いて天候の南へと移した。以来、桐原は廃墟となり、いつしかの繁栄を失ってしまった。岩王は諸魔人を鎮め、仙人夜叉は本意に戻り、リエに再び平和が訪れた。魔人千年の混戦で、桑畑が壊され、リエの民は商業、手工業は生りわいとした。そのうち優れた者が手を組み、七星、 という団体を発足。これをもってリーエコーの雛形が成り立った。七星の管轄内は八門があり、あらゆる業種を含む。また戦艦軍が七星に仕え、内では民を取り締まり、外ではあやかしを退治した。これが岩王帝君の統治である。
初、炎王降旨、退海潮、立天衡、镇西流。民遂安生、开山以采玉，凿岩以通达，巨石以为寨。有言，山孕育则有会，故名之曰山会寨。其实，天衡之名多以采矿为业，往来千里皆无凭者。注曰：山会寨今而为山会岩，久经颓落，化为山石，不复初世风貌。有成王魔神名归中者，与炎王交好，设强弩拱为天衡，曰归中基。又虑其民众居天衡北，耕田为业。其盛时阡陌交通，是任农田引至，石门而不绝。归中常谓炎王：今我黎民，皆安居乐业，积通归乡，莫如民至归黎云。炎王称善，归黎云故而得其名。注曰：后诸魔神魔位，大乱聚齐，虽诸仙人奋战力薄，然战事杂乱。归黎炎深受混战之苦，臣神归中亦轰于其中。故炎王帝君迁其民入天衡之南，归黎炎自此荒废，不复往日之繁盛。炎王平定诸魔神，仙人也插个安其位，黎月复归平和。此前魔神混战千年，丧前尽毁，黎月之名遂以上古巧工为业，其佼佼者联合一体，名至七星。故黎月港初兴继承。七星下下又有八门，内外诸业无所不包，又有千年之君听命七星，内府民众，外镇妖魔，是所谓炎王帝君之志。